Hello everyone, this is a common star 8000 patient monitor. This is the common monitor. Okay, so now we are giving a detailed demonstration for this monitor. You can see this is a 12.1 inch monitor. The diagonal, the screen size of the monitor is 12.1 inch, and you can use the monitor by using the knob. Okay. And there is shortcut keys. These are the shortcut keys in front of the monitor. Like this is for the alarm reset. If any alarm is there, you can pause the alarms for the 120 seconds. Okay, so alarm pause is there. This is to freeze the screen. This is the screen freeze button. You can freeze the screen using this button if something is there you want to see in the detail. Okay, this is for the printer. If printer is optional, if you want to print the records, you just press this button and you will get the printout. And this is the home key. This is the home key. If you are in the any menu, inside the menu, like in the review setting, you just press this button, okay, and you will come to the home screen. Okay, and this is the NIBP key. This NIBP key manual, when you will press this button, it will start the NIBP measurement. Okay, so you can see this is the main power on off button. Okay, and these are the mains indication and battery charging indication. Okay, you can see in the back light, there is in the back there is a light in the buttons. Okay, so you can use the monitor in the dark environment, like in the without disturbing the patient at the light, and in the night time you can use this monitor easily. This is the multi-angle alarm. You can see this is the multi-angle alarm. So you can see the age of the alarm light. Okay, so in the back side, if somebody is there in the back side, so this alarm light can be seen from the all angles. Okay, this alarm lights can be seen from the all angles, so you can see the age of the light. Okay, and these are the parameters. ECG, you can see the ECG, SpO2, okay, and NIBP is there. Okay, and temperature is there. Okay, dual invasive pressure is option, and cardiac CO2 is the option. CO2 monitoring is the open one option, and Masimo SpO2 is also the optional item. Okay, you can upgrade to the second temperature. Okay, and in the back side of the monitor, you can see this is European CE approved monitor. Okay, this is the mains cable connected to the monitor, and this is the earthing port for the earthing cable. Okay, this is the USB port for the data. Okay, and this is the central monitoring port. Okay, you can use this in the monitor in the central monitoring system. Okay, this is the port for the recorder, optional printer. You can attach the printer here. This is the option, and you can see the handle of the monitor. This is very easy to carry and lightweight. I'm just holding the monitor with one hand. Okay, and you can see it. Okay, this is the very lightweight monitor. Okay, now let us come to the user interface. Okay, all the points we will cover one by one. You can see the in the bottom there is menu. Okay, and this area is the waveform. Okay, this is the waveform section. This is numerical area section. This is the numerical area section, numerical. This is the waveform section. You can see two ECG waveform, one respiration is there, one plethysmograph is there. Okay, plethysmograph waveform, temperature, and this is the SpO2. You can see the pulse rate here. Okay, this is coming from the SpO2. This is the SpO2 saturation, and very important, you can see a perfusion index. PI value is there, and this is the bar for the signal strength. Okay, and this is the NIBP reading, you can see, and mean pressure. Okay, now let us come to the main, the one main menu, alarm reset, NIBP start is there. Okay, screens format would be there in the screen section. Review, you can see all the trends and details, table, events, you can see alarm setup and standby, and this is the for the central monitoring system. Okay, And let us go to the main menu. We will discuss one by one. In the main menu, you can see the manage patient. You can add the patients in this section. Alarm setup, review, screen configuration. Let us go to the manage menu patients. Okay, and you can admit the patient. You can previous record. You can delete the previous record. You can adult, pediatric, and neonatal. You can use the monitor for all type of patients. Okay, so pacemaker is there. Pacemaker detection, you can switch it on. So pacing is there. On off, you can make the patient pacemaker detection. Admit the patient. Patient, you can discharge the patient. Okay, and in the alarm setup, you can set all the limits of the alarm. Okay, like heart rate, SpO2, pulse rate, NIBP, mean diagnose, diastolic and systolic, respiration, temperature 1-2, temperature difference, all the alarms you can set under this menu. Okay, and alarm volume you can set from this menu. 1 to 10 is the scale for the alarm. Okay, and this is the review option. You can see the trends, NIBP review, alarm events review, and waveform review. You can see the detailed waveform under this section. You can print the waveform even if you have the printer, inbuilt printer, and you can see the raw waveform. Okay, and now no waveform is recorded now. Okay, you can see all the alarms, physiological alarms and technical alarms both. Okay, and in the NIBP review, you can see the NIBP table, full table. Okay, okay, and in the trend review, you can see the trends. Okay, heart rate, SpO2 trend, SpO2 trend, and NIBP trend you can see, and you can set the scale. Like you can see now, there is 9 21 32 21 33. Now scale is with the 1 minute. Okay, regulation, so you can set the regulation 5 second 10 second 1 minute, whatever you want. Like if you want the regulation 5 seconds, then you can see 5 second, 5 hours, this is for 5 hours. Okay, 5 minutes, 5 minutes, this is for 10 minutes you can set. Okay, and you can see the trend table even. You can see the trend table. There is the trend table for all parameters. Okay, now let us go to the NIBP review, and I have already shown the NIBP review. Okay, now let us go to the screen configuration. You can adjust the brightness of the monitor, key light, this key light. You can switch it on and off from this area. Screen layouts, you can set the screen layouts, how many waveform you want, where you want all the parameters. Okay, where you want to display, or like you, if you want the big font, you can set the big font and standard screen from this area. Okay, this is the privacy mode, and under the screens you can see there is 8 type of screens: standard, big font, trend, OxyCRG, least face, bed view. You can see the other bed on this monitor screen, and 7 ECG leads, and 7 leads in the half screen. You can see 7 ECG lead and other parameters. You can see there is 8 type of screen formats in this monitor. You can see the 7 lead ECG, full 7 lead ECG. This is also one screen format. Okay, and you can see the big font. You can see this is the big font screen. Okay, ECG respiration, temperature, SpO2, plethysmograph. Okay, and one more screen I'll show you. You can see the list screen. List. This is the list screen. You will see all the NIV measurements in this area, and with the list you will see the other parameters also. Okay, NIVP measurements and other parameters, history you can see in this list. Okay, now volume setup, you can set up the alarm volume, QRS volume, like QRS beep volume you can set up, pulse volume and key volume you can set up. Okay, in this area. Now let us go to the calculations. You have in this menu, you have the calculations, drug dose calculations, hemodynamic calculations, oxygenation calculations and ventilation calculations and renal calculations. Okay, under the hemodynamic you can set all the parameters under this area. Okay, and let us go to the drug dose calculations. You can set all, you can do all the calculation under this menu. Okay, and if we come to the document manage, you can manage the document, record, print settings. Okay, event setup, measurement, you see the measurement setup, you can see ECG setup, you can see all the parameters setting can be done from here. Okay, ECG, under the ECG setup you can set the lead, 5 lead cable, 3 lead cable, auto, what type of setting you want, heart rate source, like you want the heart rate from SpO2 or ECG, you can set from this area. Okay, and you can set the ECG alarms and ST analysis, arrhythmia analysis. Okay, arrhythmia analysis, you can see other setups, you can see the pacemaker on off, notch filter. Now this monitor is in the demo mode. Okay, so you would not be able to set these parameters right now. Okay, next is under the measurement setup, you can see the SpO2, pulse rate settings, NIVP settings. In the NIVP, you can see the patient types, adult, pediatric and neonatal patients. Okay, so you can set the NIVP to the neonatal patients and you can see all the settings will be done automatically. And you can see the alarm, because parameters alarm has been changed as per the neonatal patient settings. Okay, so now you can see the alarm is blinking in the red, so there is high priority alarm. Okay, because pulse rate is showing as too low, because in the NIV, in the neonatal patient setting, the limit is 200 is the higher limit and 100 is the lower limit, so it is showing as the 60, because pulse heart rate is showing as 60 and pulse rate is also showing as 60, so it is giving the alarm. Okay, and there is NIVP alarm. Okay, so let me take it back to the normal settings. Okay, so otherwise it will keep disturbing us. Okay, so I'll set up the NIVP and I'll change the patient to the adult patient. Okay, so now you can see the alarm is limit is 120 and 50. Okay, ECG alarm limits, 120 is the higher limit and 50 is the lower limit. Okay, in the main menu you can see the calculations I have shown, the load configuration, maintenance is there. Okay, you can your engineer, biomedical engineer can do all the settings in the maintenance area. Okay, and in the configuration, this is also like maintenance. Okay, there is measurement setting, you can see the temperature, invasive pressure setting, atrial CVP, CO2 settings. Okay, ETCO2 is optional in this monitor. Okay, so all settings related to parameters can be done in this area. Okay, so now let us go to the just alarm reset. You can see, reset all the alarms from here. Screen formats we have shown you already, like big font, trends, OxyCRJ, least face, view, BAT, XAML, ADCG, all the screen formats. There is 8 type of screen formats. Okay, review. We have shown you a trend review, an IBP review, alarms. This can be done from this screen directly. Okay, alarm setups and standby. Standby mode is there. In the standby mode, this will not give any alarm. Like patient is going for the CT or MRI. Okay, you just put the monitor in the standby mode. Okay, and it will not give any alarm because, and when patient is back, you just press the continue button. Okay, so these are the setting for the central monitoring station. Network, go to the network setup. There is a wireless central monitoring is also there in this monitor, but we will recommend to use the wired setting because sometimes wireless settings create problem in the connections. Okay, due to curtains in the ICU or NICU. Okay, so you can set the IP address, subnet mask, MAC setting. So this your networking engineer will do all these settings, or our engineer will do all these settings during the installations. Okay, so you can, in the upper side you can see, you can change the patient admit, you can admit the patient, you can change the patient info, you can discharge the patient, you can, all the settings can be done from here in this area. Okay, and this is the waveform. Now we come to the waveforms. Let us press on the ECG waveform. So you can cascading, you can switch the cascading on or off. So now there is only one waveform. Okay, you just go and switch on the cascading. So there is one waveform continuously. So cascading is on. Okay, and you can change the waveform, sweep speed, gain, lead, which lead you want to see, and channel formats. Okay, filter settings like monitoring or surgery filter or diagnostic filter, all the settings can be done from this area. Okay, so respiration settings related to waveform, sweep speed, and all these things can be done from this area. And even you can change the color of the waveform. Okay, in the SpO2 settings, okay, you can see the signal strength and sensitivity and alarms and all these settings. Okay, and temperature in the ECG numerical, you can see the all the ECG settings, ST segment, ST arrhythmia analysis. In the arrhythmia analysis, you can set up all the, you will get all type of arrhythmia here, heart rate, pulse, extreme tachycardia, tachy bradycardia, okay, extreme bradycardia, ventricular bradycardia, okay, and PVC, okay, and ventricular rate, ventricular PVC. There is all type of arrhythmias is there in this monitor. Okay, and so you can set up all these, because now monitor is in the demo mode, so we would not be able to show you. Okay, and other setup related to filters and all these things. Okay, this monitor is very advanced. Okay, you can see the SpO2 settings. Okay, signal, and you can see the PI perfusion index here. Okay, SpO2 perfusion index, what is the signal strength, you can see from there. And in the NIBP menu, you can set the automatic and manual from this area. Okay, like mode you want, which measurement mode, like automatic or manual is there. Okay, so this is in demo mode, so we would not be able to set it here. Okay, in the demo mode, other setup, alarms limit, you can change all the alarms limit. Okay, from this area. Okay, so we have given you a detailed demonstration. Only two parameters left, this is the temperature, okay, and pulse rate. So in this section you can set the temperature alarm, and in the pulse rate section you can set up the pulse rate alarm, and you can also set up the pulse rate source, like you want the pulse rate from ECG, SpO2 or NIBP. Okay, from which parameter you want the pulse rate. Okay, so this is the 12.1, again 12.1 inch high-end monitors. Touch screen is options, you can buy this monitor with a touch screen also. Okay, but the knob is standard option here. It is easy to use with the knob also. Okay, and this is very lightweight monitor. Okay, You can use in the transport, ICU, NICU, in your any area you can use this monitor. USB port is there to carry the data, and central monitoring port is there. Okay, this is from the common star 8000 monitor. Thank you for watching our video. Okay, this was the detailed demonstration for I want to show you the accessories of this monitor. Okay, so this is the SpO2 sensor. Okay, so SpO2 sensor will be connected. You can see the color coding. Okay, so SpO2 sensor will be connected here. Okay, and now this is the ECG cable. You can see the color, green color. So ECG cable will be connected here. Okay, and this is the NIBP cuff. Okay, so you will get one NIBP cuff as standard. We can provide you a neonatal and pediatric BP cuff. This is the NIBP cuff tube. Okay, you just connect the tube to the monitor. This is the port for the NIBP tube. Okay, you connect the tube direct to the monitor. Okay, so now it is connected. Okay, you can see, and you can connect the NIBP cuff here. Okay, so this is the power cable. Okay, and this is the temperature sensor. So this is the skin temperature sensor. We can provide both skin and rectal. Okay, these are some electrodes for the pre-use, and this is the earthing cable. Okay, so these are all, and this is the operational manual. Okay, this is the operational manual for Star 8000 monitor user manual. Okay, you will get all these accessories in a box with this monitor. Okay, and now this monitor is working on the battery, you can see. Okay, battery symbol is there. Now you can see this working on the battery. This monitor has inbuilt 2 hours inbuilt battery. Okay, so thank you very much. Thank you for watching our video. So this was the detailed demonstration for Star 8000 monitor. Thank you. So I'm just switching off this. Okay, this monitor is sitting down. Okay, thank you.